I get this question very often as to when to begin preparation and, you know, with respect to students or whether you're a working professional, and generally when do people start preparing. So for FRM levels 1 and 2, of course there'll be a lot of other factors which will matter in terms of, you know, when to begin preparation in terms of how, what is your working hours, which college you're in, as in your college hours and your subject and all of those other factors. But in general, if you're seeing FRM level 1 is going to be taking you approximately 5 to 6 months. See, what it used to happen earlier was, I'll tell you, that in general what I've seen is people used to study in 4-5 months or so earlier. 4-5, maximum 6 months, they would prepare for a level. As, you know, over the last few years, 5-6-7 years or so, what I've noticed is that the duration that people are taking, students are taking in order to take an exam is increasing, because possibly because the focus level is going down. The students want to sit now, they want to do 10-minute lecture, then they want to take a break, then do 20-minute lecture. That is not how you study for finance. I'll be very, very honest with you and very straightforward. It is not how you study. So all these micro modules and all of these nonsense does not work. When you're studying finance, you have to sit at a stretch. So even in live classes right now, like for example, the students are going to be sitting for 2.5-3 hours at a stretch. So you'll have to sit at long, for long duration, in order to grasp a concept. I'm explaining a derivative or a concept or something, and that there is a flow of that topic. So you have to concentrate, you have to focus. So that is very important. So understand these things. You have to study very well and be an outlier. I always say, because everybody has got a concentration issue, and you know they're not able to switch off their phones, etc., and work for long continuous chunks of hours, or study or work as well. So try to be an outlier and try to be there, you know, differentiate yourself in that aspect. Anyway, so right now on an average what we see is students are taking approximately 6 to 8 months in order to prepare. Students, those who are full-time students, because they generally have more luxury in terms of the hours they can take out to study, as in along with college and all, it's generally 4-5-6 months also. So I see a lot of students starting 4-5 months before the exam, but on an average I would say 6 months before the exam. And working professional also, I've seen people starting 5-6 months before the exam also, but most of the chunk is going to be around 7 months or so. And 8 months is a decent time, 8 to 10 months. If your job is more stressful, or you know, you have, let's say Saturday also you have to work half day or so, in that case then you can stretch it for a longer duration, 8 months, 9 months or so. And when you're looking at the FRM level 2 exams, in that case also it's more or less similar. It's just that for level 2, I've seen working professionals take a little longer, because the number of chapters is more and all, so they take a little longer duration in terms of covering the curriculum. And obviously before the exam date, so say for example you have your exam date, you have to start preparing 6 to 8 months before the exam date. When you're looking at revision, please leave this revision time frame of 15-17 days or so, 15 to 20 days for FRM part 1, but for FRM part 2 you leave a 21 to 28 days time frame before that, before the exam. And within that, and before that, you need to start your preparation. Obviously there'll be people who'll be starting much later, there'll be people who could be starting earlier. That will depend on different circumstances. 1 or 2 months plus minus you can do based on other factors. We'll discuss that. Now how do we get to this understanding? I've already told you on an average it's 5-6 months is what is there. Working professional average would be still 7 months or so. And normally what happens is, what I advise the students to do is that you start preparing, you start putting in a lot of effort. And as you move towards the exam date, now you have, say for example, you have your exam in November or December or whatever, and your deadline to register is, let's say, in the month of July. So you at least target, even if you're a working professional starting 5 months or 6 months before the exam, you at least study for a couple of months, see how many chapters you've covered, and then you see whether in the remaining time frame you'll be able to cover the remaining syllabus or not. And accordingly you decide whether to enroll or not to enroll. So whether to enroll for the coming term or whether to enroll for a later term. So say for example, my enrollment, let's say my due date to register for the exam is in month of July end, and the exam is taking place in November. Now I'm not sure whether I'll be able to take the exam in November or not. Now what I've seen is, suppose a student is starting in May and he's confused. Now the student in May and June will keep on wasting time just thinking about it, getting worried and getting stressed that no, I want to complete the exam first, faster, but I don't want to study so much, but I don't want to put in so much effort. And they will keep on just overthinking about it and waste all their time. So what you do, don't irritate about yourself about it. Simply May, June, July, you study for 3 months very thoroughly and you put in all your hard work and all your effort. And then at the end of 3 months, towards the end of July, at the, let's say 25th of July or so, then you decide that okay, in 3 months I've covered this much, so in August, September, October, what will I be able to cover based on that? Will I be able to cover? Yes, go ahead, take the exam. No, don't register for the November batch, register for the batch next. to remember. That is how you need to decide. That is how you should decide things. You need to have more information, more accurate information before deciding as to when to enroll or when to register for the exam. So you start studying. I've seen people waste a lot of time. And also I'll tell you, there's this, I had mentioned in another lecture also, Parkinson's law. So if you allot 6 months for a time for a particular project, you'll take 6 months. If you allocate 10 months, you're going to take 10 months. If you're going to be allocating 5 months, you are going to take 5 months time frame. So whatever time frame you allot, that is the time you take to do that. And most of the students, obviously, when I see them to begin preparation, they are relatively slow, obviously getting into the mode, they're getting in the flow of the study and all, and more intense studying, as in they're concentrating more, because obviously as the exam gets closer, 6 months now, 3 months to go, 2 months to go. Now, obviously, there is more energy intensity in terms of studying, and there is more hours, concentrated long hours towards the exam. So if you're able to push yourself to do that, at the very beginning, I'm going to be giving that concentrated effort. So the way I will study 2 months before the exam, I'll start studying 6 months before the exam in the same manner, then obviously you'll have no problem. Are you understanding the idea? So in that case, you'll be able to manage the exam in the shorter duration. So obviously I would always recommend that, you know, you want to pace up your career. There's so much to do even after that, and your job is always going to get difficult, your work is always going to get difficult as you move forward. But still, depending on your profile, depending on a lot of other factors, you may increase this time duration by a month or two. So I'll discuss the factors later, based on which you need to take a very, very informed decision. See, the decision is going to be yours. You have to decide, and you have to start studying for it. So, but think about all the factors, understand all the pointers, and then take a very, very informed decision. When you're looking at FRM level 1, we've got about 60, 65 chapters or so. FRM level 2 will have about 100 chapters. Don't get worried looking at the number of chapters, because when you see the lecture hours, they're going to be more or less similar. It is more in FRM level 1 with less number of chapters. So it's around 200 hours for 60 chapters or so, and around 180 hours for about 100 chapters or so. The reason is that FRM part 2 has got smaller chapters. That is one. Second reason is that when you're looking at FRM part 1, it is a building base. You're learning quants, you're learning portfolio, fixed income, derivatives, you're learning all the topics new, fixed income, risk, and also it is for the first time you're learning the topic, so a lot of basics have to be taught, because we're introducing terms. So obviously I take longer in duration in order to explain the concept, because you have to build your base very, very strong. In level 2, what happens is you know all the terms. So asset-backed securities, dead call option, put option, you know all the terms, everything you've studied and understood over here. You already know the terms very, very well. Now we build upon that and we move towards different subjects in level 2. So in level 2, the duration is lower, lesser as compared to, I would rather say it's very, very similar that way, but the duration is lesser as compared to level 1 curriculum, part 1 curriculum. So that is the reason, because part 1, again, the basics take time, because you're learning new subjects altogether from scratch, new concepts and all. And part 1 is also more numerical as compared to part 2. So that is also the reason why we take a little more time in part 1 with so many formulas, derivations and all. Part 2 takes a little less time because of that. It is relatively more theoretical as compared to part 1. And also the time taken to study, since there are new concepts, new formulas and everything, you take about on an average 3-4 hours per chapter. You can actually cover it in three hours also. On an average, I would say 3 hours. There are quite a few small chapters in part one also. But the point is that you will have to concentrate and study very, very well when you're sitting down to study. But I would still on a safe side take 4 hours or so. And 2 hours on an average for FRM part two would be sufficient when you're studying. And practicing each chapter could be approximately 1.5 hours for maybe part one, and maybe an hour or even maybe a little less than that for part two. So given that, you can do a simple calculation. About 5.5 into 60 would be 300. So it would be approximately 500, 550 hours or so. And when you're looking at part two curriculum, 200 plus this into 60. And over there, you'll have around 300 plus 180, around 450, 480 hours or so. So 450, 480 hours. So the duration, that way it might seem that FRM part 2 has less hours of study, and still I have given you more time over here to prepare for FRM part 2 curriculum. Because I've seen with 100 chapters, you know, there is always somehow people get worried, students get worried, and they want to take a longer duration for part 2 curriculum. Also, one of the reasons would be that retention. As I told you, part 1 is more intuitive, it is more numerical as compared to part 2 curriculum. So in part 2, the revision takes time, because retention is required, because it is not that numerical. So I would rather say that, you know, you need to do a little extra time you need to take over here for revision in order to retain, because the content is not as numerical as part 1. Right, so this is the reason why I would suggest you to go for a 6 to 10 months or so for part 2 exams. But see, all these things aside, the best, simplest solution to study and to decide how much time you're going to take is not debate over all these things. You've got all the information, we'll understand all the other factors also, and then you simply start studying. And before the exam due date, the registration deadline, let's say for the May exam, the deadline would be, let's say, 31st of January or so. So till 31st January, you study. Till whatever is the deadline, take a 5 days buffer time in case credit card payment and all you have to make with the institute. So very simple idea is you start studying. Before the deadline, we will take a call that how much I have studied in so and so time, how much will I be able to, how much is left, and will I be able to cover that, leaving aside time for revision before the exam date. And accordingly, we'll take a call. So the best way to decide is to start studying. Do not waste time. I see a lot of students waste a lot of time. So do not do that. And after this, we'll discuss the factors. All right. So now what are the factors that you need to consider and then evaluate as to what duration you're going to take to prepare for your examination? So the first thing is, are you a college student or you are a working you're working and studying together? If you are a college student, in that case, what are your courses? If you're looking at a BCom, BBA, etc. courses, generally it is, the load is lighter, and even with engineering. So I was surprised, I'll not take the names of the colleges and all, but XYZ engineering colleges, I used to think that people must be studying a little too much. But these guys are also very chill, they don't study so much as I was probably assuming. But yes, eco honors students have a lot to study. So it depends on your college hours also, what is the duration of your college hours and all, and what is the attendance requirement, etc. So I had a very, very stringent attendance requirement and all when I was in college, but we had the whole day off in order to study because we had an early morning college, 6 to 10 o'clock in the morning. So what is the college hours? And we didn't have to study much, so for the college exams, because I was studying CA and CFA and all of those things were going on one after the other, so I did not have to study as such for college exams. So what is the duration, as in terms of your course, how easy or difficult it is, as in what timing, the college duration hours and all are being consumed? Do you have to take classes for college separately beyond college? I doubt, but still, eco honors and all, I've seen students taking that. And the difficulty level of your course and whatever you are taking of your exams and all. So, and also your exam date. So at times, if your exam date is coinciding with your exam term, if you want to take the exam in the May month or November month, so if the exam is coinciding with that, so that you have to check. So these are the factors you'll have to check. Now, obviously, when I recall my CA inter exams, we used to have 7-8 papers of CA inter and 7-8 papers of college semester exam. So ours was one day semester, one day CA, one day semester, one day CA inter. So I have taken exams that way, and I don't think that, and since it is computer based testing and you can schedule the exam as per the window, so I think there should not be a problem even if you have your semester exam one of these levels coinciding together. I don't think it should be a problem, but then you will have to figure out based on your college and all these factors. But I think it should be doable. For eco honors students, I find it a little difficult, but other than that, all the other students, I think it should be doable. You prepare in a little earlier, complete the curriculum in time, and then just keep revision for that time frame. You'll be able to manage. It depends on how much you want to push yourself and how quickly you want to wrap up things. So obviously, I wanted to speed up my career. Post-COVID, a lot of students had a problem because, you know, they did not want to delay their career. I would take almost 2 exams plus semester, so 3 exams every 6 months in order to speed up my career. So you will have to decide how quickly you want to do things. Now that I was not studying properly or was not absorbing my concepts and all, so don't do that. As in, do not make a shallow base or a foundation for your concepts and all. But you will have to evaluate based on a lot of your circumstances. If you're a working professional, in that case, what is the kind of job role do you have? So there are people who have relatively lighter, you know, very strict timings, and absolute weekends are totally off. Working hours are very, very strict and restricted. But there are people in consulting, Big Four, etc., where the working hours are relatively more extensive. So that becomes a challenge, and that is why they will have to increase the duration for exams. So if you are supposed to be taking like 7-8 months to prepare, then you increase it to 11-12 months, so that you are kind of pacified also, as in it's not so much of a challenge. And also, on the exam date or around the exam date, do you have seasonal pressure? Quarter ending could be there, or you could have audit and all, people in audit profession, auditor, year ending and etc. So those, that aspect also you need to check. There is a lecture that I have made on how to manage studies with a full-time job. Working professionals need to definitely watch that lecture, attend that lecture, and manage their studies and work together alongside. Also, one thing you have to understand is things are always going to get difficult. Class 8 was difficult than class 6, 10 was difficult than class 8. Professional exams are getting more difficult than school exams. So the difficulty level is going to increase. You will not have less responsibilities at work. You will not have less working hours during work. you will not have less difficulty as you move forward. Also, if you are doing an MBA, so in that case, MBA college will have its own pressures in term pressure in terms of assignments and competitions, etc. So you'll have to figure out. But then the MBA student might have a little overlap in terms of studying a couple of papers in finance and give an edge in terms of placement and all that. There's another lecture I have posted, should engineers take up CFA or FRM, MBA should take up CFA, FRM and all. So I'm trying to answer every single possible question that students get. But anyway, so the working professionals will have to evaluate based on all these factors. But things are always going to get difficult. You will have to, as I was telling you, that, you know, read a book like Deep Work by Cal Newport. Read these things, 4-hour work week. 4-hour work week, maybe only if you're a working professional for at least 2, 3, 4, 5 years or so. Then, you know, you'll have to work on things in terms of focus, retention. You'll have to improve yourself in all these aspects in order to be able to manage things, because life and work is going to get difficult. We need to get better at it. And that is how you'll grow. So figure out all these factors. Obviously, depending on these factors, you'll have to either have a longer duration for exam, or as in delay the exam term, or you will be able to take the exam a little quickly by completing your curriculum and preparation in 4, 5, 6 months or so, 4, 5 months or 6, 7 months or so. Or you might need more time, like 10, 11 months or let's say 5, 6, 7 months or so, depending on how you're going about it. Other situations you have to see, one is the financial situation. Of course, it is very, very important. So you have to check the first deadline. So generally the institutes have multiple deadlines, first, second, early bird, whatever they call it. So the first deadline, so in case you're you want to defer by one term so that you have an early deadline and you are able to register for the exam and save some cost over there, or you want to wait for scholarships and all, at CF Institute, for example, provides scholarships. FRM Institute, not so many, I haven't heard as such. So you'll have to evaluate that. So it is absolutely fine. You take more time, you be more prepared, because also if you have to reappear for an exam, you have to bear the entire exam fee. So it might be a good idea that, or if you're not prepared, you have to try to get it deferred. For example, FRM Institute charges for a deferral. CF Institute does not charge, but there is very unlikely situation that they will allow you to defer your exam until unless there is a medical emergency, etc. So you figure out all those things. So if the financial situation is a little troublesome, in that case, you take a little extra 3-4 months or so and you take the exam one term later. That is absolutely fine. Don't take unnecessary pressure and put pressure on the family. The next criteria you need to see is, another thing that happens is students generally, after clearing level one, they can start level one preparation in order to not delay their preparation for level two. Because if the results come out, then you start your level two preparation, it could be a little delayed. So what I've seen is, just immediately after level one, students want to prepare for level two. So what I have kind of tried to do for the students, for my students, is that in the live class, so students, L1 cleared student can sit in level two classes, nothing has to be done. For video students or online students, basically what we do is that you can register for the next level. You clear your exam, which I'm very, very confident and hopeful that you will. Once you clear the exam, you start preparing for level two, and you continue preparing for level two, because you've already been studying for it for about a month, month and a half or so. In case you do not clear, then we block the level two ID and we reactivate the level one ID. So you study for level one. Once level one is completed, then you again reactivate the level two ID and continue with level two preparation. Obviously, if there is any change or additions, etc., in the curriculum for level two, all those are provided on Google Drive to the students. But so this is what we do. We cannot send the lectures in advance do refunds and all. That does not work with this. The only thing we can do is we can block the level 2 ID and activate it later on, in case you don't clear. If you've cleared, then absolutely fine. Nothing has to be done. You continue with your level 2 preparation. So in case a student wants to start preparing for the next level before the result of the first level, that is one thing we can do if you want to speed up. Most on an average, what I've seen is students generally start 5 to 6 months before the exam, and that is what is used to be. I've already told you, it has increased. So average has increased. Basically, if you start studying, if you needed 5-6 months earlier, if students used to prepare 5-6 months before, now it has become 7-8 months. If somebody would take 5-7 months, 8-10 months before, now they are taking 12 months plus or so. So the average has increased. What I'm trying to tell you is the average has increased, not on a level wise basis, I'm saying, but on an average, the average itself has increased. The other thing is that students generally have been taking 4-5 months to prepare, but nowadays even students are taking more time, and also they want to take more time to practice. I think the same output or work studying, they want to do in a longer duration because of that focus level going down. So there are too many distractions, and that is a reality. I mean, I'm not complaining or something, but we need to consciously recognize that and start working towards it, because that is how I want to be most productive. Obviously, at times I get distracted because there are so many things happening. I have to do this, I have to do that. So the multitasking also becomes a challenge. So I also keep on continuously reading about different concepts, different things and all, in order to and work on my routine, my discipline and my focus level in order to be very, very productive. So we will have to start learning and start working towards it. So, and of course, practice is required, because I'm seeing the difficulty level of questions, then the amount of time it takes to study and absorb and practice and take the exam. So I'm kind of seeing that the average time that is being taken is increased. But of course, the average duration that a student, full-time student takes is lesser, and a working professional takes is longer as compared. And that is also because the student is already in the flow of studying. He has more hours to contribute on a daily basis. A working professional is more distracted, I would say, not distracted, but more occupied in terms of office responsibilities. And a working professional would probably have more family responsibilities as well. And also maybe not too much in the flow of studying. So that could be a reason why working professionals generally take a little extra time in terms of preparing for the exam. But you know, to be very honest, what I've seen is, even though students start preparing 10 months, 11 months early at times, but from what I've seen is most of the students actually study more, the duration and the focus level increases as you approach the exam. Because right now, if say for example 8 months are left, I'm like, okay, 8 months are left, why do I need to study right now? Why do I need to cancel a party and sit back home and study and all? So generally it is the hours that you're spending, that you're investing in studying, and the hours that you're working, and and those priorities are kind of different. But as you move closer, okay, only 6 months are left, only 4 months are left, the duration increases, the focus increases, the intensity of studying increases as you move towards the exam. So there are students, if you are starting late, you can start at a very, very, very concentrated, with a lot of intensity, you can start studying and you can manage. I'll come to that. So now there is focus level, attention span. You will have to evaluate yourself that what level of focus you have, and how much are you able to pay attention in the classes and with studying and all. What is your attention span? Based on that, you'll have to decide your background in terms of education and work. There are people I know, students I know, who've say for example studied CA Inter, so obviously some subjects might get easier. Who've studied CA Final, some more subjects will get easier. Or who studied finance in BCom or something, who have done an MBA and then they are doing this, who are studying, so they have a basic idea about the subjects and all. Or in terms of working, there are people working in derivatives, in fixed income or in equity research, etc. So they have some idea. So if you have some background, obviously that gives an edge, because your grasping power of concepts increases, but your work is going to be different as compared to what you're studying. Not different as in the concept or the term is different, but you'll have to put in more effort, more depth, you'll have to get into it. So that part you also you need to see. So if you're in the zone in terms of you have some educational background or some working knowledge of certain subjects or something, then obviously you save a little time and you'll be grasping faster. Your flow of study. So the thing is that generally I've seen that students obviously are already studying for their college or etc., or immediately just after your graduation you're studying, so then it's easier to be in the study mode. Working professionals find it a little difficult to get in the mode of study, and there is a major apprehension, especially if somebody is getting into studies after 10 years, 12 years, 15 years or so. So I am studying right now and I plan to intend to study throughout life. But working professionals also, what I see, there is just the first step is always a problem. When you're stepping into, let's say, you're on the sea beach and you're just stepping into the cold water. So the moment, till the time you get into the water, you have that apprehension. Once you're in the water, then you don't feel cold at all. That is the same thing. So working professionals obviously will be finding the first 2-3 chapters a little cumbersome or a little challenging in order to, concentrate, focus and get into it. But after 3-4 chapters, they will also sit with the red pen and the blue pen, marking, underlining, understanding, enjoying the studies and the process. We're always going to be enjoying learning process. So that is not a problem. But the first 2-3 chapters is going to be a problem in order to get into the flow of study. So there is always this apprehension that resistance to change to get into it. But the flow of study and long durations of study is very, very important if you want to do very well conceptually. I have seen issues in terms of family situation, not enough room to study at times, so distractions are there. Say for example family responsibilities, I don't want to get into the gender discussions and all, but it is unfortunate or what to say, but of course women have more responsibilities in the house is what I have seen. I'm not debating whether they should have, they shouldn't have equality and everything, that is kept aside, but I'm just talking practicality from what I have seen. So from what I have seen, they generally have, and obviously they have to give their, again, you might be questioning me, but they have that instinct to give more time to the children and all. And even for the fathers. So I have so many students who have kids and all. So the fathers also have to give a lot of time to the child and to household responsibilities. So your family situation in terms of your family responsibilities. So as a student, as a bachelor, obviously that responsibility, this time frame is not consumed. But as, you know, with that family situation, you'll have to give the right expectations also to your family members and friends around that you're studying. You'll be giving them less time because it is good for your career, your growth, your learning, etc. So they have to manage with that. Instead of continuous nagging, rather they should be supporting you in your quest for learning, in your approach to study. So you have to give clear expectation and you have to evaluate this as well. You cannot neglect your child and all. So you'll have to figure this out, and accordingly you'll have to take the exam, so schedule your exam. Hours you can stretch. So I have seen working professionals also, you know, you start studying at 6 a.m. in the morning on Saturday and Sunday. You continue till 2 o'clock in the afternoon. You're done with a good 7 hours studying per day. Break and all will be there, breakfast and all that. So 7 hours, 14 hours. And you can take out 2-3 hours, 5 o'clock in the morning to 8 o'clock in the morning on Monday to Friday. So you can have a good 15 hours on the weekdays and 14 hours on the weekend and have a good 29-30 hours. And that is a very good amount of time chunk that you're contributing in terms of studying. So it is more about discipline and consistency. And Saturday and Sunday after 2 o'clock you enjoy. You have to sleep at the same time, get up at the same time, get up early in the morning. Biologically you are made to study early in the morning. Nobody's a night person and all. So you have to work. You have to learn all these things in terms of being productive, in terms of, you know, studying well. So hours you can stretch. Can you sit for 7-8 hours at a stretch? You'll have to get in the habit. Don't say that I cannot do that. That is an identity problem. Atomic Habits, James Clear, read that book. So you have to get into the habit where you're able to stretch for hours. How have you been as a student? So these factors also matter. So I have been a good student throughout. So obviously I'll probably have a little more confidence in terms of getting into it, or I'm habituated to working for and studying for long hours and all. I have seen quite a few students, actually one particular comes to my mind, Akash, for example, who's not done very well in class 11 and 12. And then, you know, he has been doing extraordinarily well after that because he understood, he realized the importance, and he's that hard work, that junoon, you know, that motivation is there. So it is immaterial as to how you have been as a student, but the habits stick. You know, as a student, again, I want two pens, I want to practice, I want to study properly. There are students who are very fond of making notes and all, I've seen, like to write properly, maintain their books, and respect, always respect your books. That is very important. So anyway, so these things also factor in. Not very important. Are you willing to work hard? Are you that desperate to crack the exam, to learn, to grow in your career? So you will have to be very, very driven, because consistently 6 months you have to work. See, understand, normally what happens is students start studying, then it dips, and then 5-7 days, 8 days they will waste. You can't let this happen 5-7 days. In one day itself you will have to rise up. So I discuss all these things, how to manage your energy to be productive and all that. So you'll have to work around these things. You'll have to be very, very careful. You'll have to be very, very hardworking. So these things you have to see before you take a call around this, right? So consider all these factors before you decide in terms of taking when to take the exam. So the average and the duration for each level I've told you, but you'll have to just tweak it a little bit, maybe add a couple of months or minus a couple of months based on these factors. Nothing big deal. Just 1 or 2 months plus or minus, nothing more than that is needed. And lot of discipline and conviction is needed. So basically, even then, students I see are often confused. So you start studying right now. Do not wait. I see a lot of people wasting time, you know, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, they'll think that should I take the exam in this term or not take the exam in this term. And then after 3 weeks, they'll realize that in these 3 weeks, had I studied, I would have been able to take the exam. So I'm contemplating for 3 weeks, should I take in the next May or not? And after 3 weeks, they wasted a lot of time, and then they will decide that if these 3 weeks I would have studied, I could have taken the exam in May. Now I cannot study. Now I cannot take the exam in May. So the idea is that you immediately start studying. You start pushing yourself. You set targets. And I told you that people, students study more towards the exam. As close a target you have, more deadly the target, not deadly I would say, but more difficult or stringent the target you have, the better you do. There are two laws I can talk about, 80-20 principle. 80% of your studies are done closer to the exam in terms of volume and in terms of quality. And also Parkinson's law I can talk about. So if you set 6 months for a task, you will take 6 months to do that task. If you set 4 months for a task, you will take 4 months to do the task. So you read about Parkinson's law. So my advice is you start studying immediately. Then say, for example, this is the first deadline to register for the exam with the institute. On this deadline, you decide that I have completed sufficient number of chapters. I'll be able to complete the remaining syllabus here, then I register for this term. If I will not be able to complete the curriculum in this much, if I have not been able to study sufficient number of proportionate chapters, so therefore I will not be able to complete the curriculum here, then you register for that exam. At least immediately start studying, push yourself, and whenever is the first deadline to register for the exam, let's say the first deadline for May is over here. This is May exam, and over here I had a target that if I complete 20-25 chapters, I will be in a position to complete the curriculum and revise and take the exam in May. Then I will register. If I cannot complete that many 20-25 chapters, I'm left with only, I've done only 5-10 chapters, then skip May, register for the next term. So you immediately start studying, don't waste time, set good targets for yourself, work very hard. Time is very important. I wanted to pace up my career. I told you, I took too many exams together, and even till now, obviously now work is a priority, but still, I mean, obviously, yeah, my part of my work is also studying, but anyways, leave that aside. So you have to, so you decide your term over here, the deadline for whatever is the first, whenever is the first deadline of the exam. So start studying, don't waste time, don't get distracted. Distraction and all is a big problem. Work on yourself and start figuring out all these things. Start reading about all these things, how to get better in terms of, you know, managing work, output, productivity, time management, focus, very important. There are certain students, it's a little unusual question I get, but there are certain students who want to register 1 or 2 or 3 months before the exam. So at times what happens is they've already been studying roughly and they want to strengthen their concepts and all, so that is a different question altogether. At times there are students who are not able to defer, or the time to defer has gone, and they are just taking an attempt because they've anyways invested the money and they've registered for the exam and all that. In that case, what happens is they study with very limited hope because they've barely studied and you've just got a month or two left for the exam. So in that case, they just take the exam for the sake of it. But I recommend you to study very, very strongly, because even in 20 days, if you do 200 hours of lectures, 10 hours per day, and you do your best in the exam, what if you clear? If you don't clear, then you extend the validity and you prepare for the next term. So that is what I can say. But obviously the probability of, as the longer duration and the more practice you do, the more the probability of clearing the exam, obviously. So the amount of time you give, the amount of hard work, not just time, not distracted time, I'm talking about effective studying time. So the more you practice, the more time you give, you're going to be obviously having a higher probability to clear the exam. So I've already given you for each level what is the average time that students take, working professionals as well as students, in order to take the exam. And based on your circumstances, you can do a plus one or minus 1 month, 1.5, 2 months maximum. That's all. And yeah, that's about it. So that is the kind of time frame you take in order to prepare for the exam, and that is how you should start, plan and start preparing for the exams. Comfortable? Complete this part.